In this video, I want to give you an affiliate marketing introduction. It's a very popular topic these days. A lot of people ask about it. A lot of people are very confused by it. So hopefully in this video, I'll totally deconfuse it and outline some ways you can actually get started with it if you want to, if it sounds appealing for you.
This video is brought to you by EpiPies Academy.
So at the root of it, really, it's not new. It's basically selling products of other companies for a commission. And this has been around before the web. The reason it's popular on the web is because the web has created a lot of digital products, and digital products can give you a big commission, because for physical products, there's just not a lot of extra room there to give a large commission. So like Amazon, which sells physical products, for example, gives on average between 5% and 9% commission. And that's relatively small, because for a digital product, because the creator of the product, the cost to them to reproduce another and another and another is zero, just copying a digital product is zero, they can give a 50% commission, 75% commission. So the commissions are tremendously more attractive online for digital products than for physical products, but you can still resell both. And now let's walk through some of the very popular sites where you can find thousands upon thousands of products. Some of them have various requirements, like a website or something else. Some have no requirements. So just if you're interested in this, try to apply to all of them, see where you get stuck and see which ones allow you to enter. Any of the ones we'll go over will have thousands of products for you to choose from to sell. The first such site is CJ.com, formerly Commission Junction. This has a lot of reputable companies that you can promote. Amazon Associates program is basically something you can sign up on the Amazon site. If you scroll to the bottom of their site, they have their Amazon Associates affiliate program link, and you can go through the steps of registering for that if you want to sell Amazon products. Clickbank.com is something a lot of people have heard of. This is only for digital products, and they have very few requirements for getting accepted to this site. Also, ShareASale.com has a little bit more reputable brands, and JVZoo.com is very similar to ClickBank. Now, the challenge isn't really to get the products to sell, because obviously there's a lot of companies who want you to resell their products. The challenge is promoting the products. That's where it's really hard. The common ways to promote the products are obviously from YouTube, from creating content on your own website and driving your traffic to buy the affiliate product. You can also participate in different forums and communities, and from there post some affiliate links, not in a spammy way, because some people will think it's spammy, but maybe if it's in a helpful way, if your link is actually for something that actually helps people there. And of course, you want to be careful of ads. A lot of people online recommend you just run Facebook ads and you'll make a lot of money. But the Facebook ads, to get good traffic, it's not that cheap, and a lot of people lose money by running ads. So I'm very conservative about recommending ads, actually, because I don't want people to just go out and plow into this and just lose money. So I'd say be careful about running ads. And of course, the whole other part of this is, on the one hand, you can just have an affiliate marketing business where maybe you have some kind of website, get traffic to the website, and the whole purpose of this website is to get people to click on your affiliate links and buy something so you get a commission. But there's another way of doing this, and that's actually something that I actually do. So for example, I sell a lot of my own products, but there are some instances where I cannot sell my own products. For example, some of my clients need a website, and I cannot sell them website hosting or website design. I just don't do that. So what do? I promote affiliate products and services that can help them with that. So it helps my clients, and it helps me because I get a commission. So I use it to fill the gaps in my business as a part of my business, as a secondary strategy to make money. So affiliate marketing can work both ways, as a number one priority of making money and as a secondary way to make extra income from scenarios where otherwise you wouldn't be able to sell to your clients. So that's effectively affiliate marketing. A lot of people online make it out like it's easy to do, but the hard part about it is promoting the products. That's really where most people, like 95%, 98% of the people who start this, who are new to this, they get stuck in the promotion part, because it's really not easy to sell.